else are they lying about?
New York City naming an official subway hero. Rykeen Wilder got the honor at a ceremony yesterday after he helped stop a man wanted for causing a train to derail. Wilder chased after the guy who threw construction debris onto those subway tracks over the weekend. That caused a train with 135 people on board to come off the tracks, and luckily no one was injured. But as part of the honor, Wilder also gets a supersized Metro card, giving him unlimited Metro and bus rides for a year.
That's a pretty good prize. I think they should just rack it on up to for life for that. If you're a coffee drinker, listen to this. A new study ranked the 100 best cities for coffee around the U.S., and they looked at a range of figures, including number of coffee shops, number of coffee drinkers, and the average price for a cup. And one of the top cities is pretty close by, actually. Atlanta came in number 10 on the list. So scoot across to Atlanta if you want some coffee. Number 3 is Portland. That one's going to take you a little bit farther to get there. Number 2 is San Francisco. And the number 1, I bet you guessed it, Seattle. No South Carolina city made the list, so maybe we are more into tea over in South Carolina. Don't know.
Maybe there's a Starbucks on every corner. Who knows? Okay, Coffee Mate has a new way to help out. You don't have to travel anywhere. They have a new creamer for sale, and it's not something you might expect. They're releasing a coffee creamer that tastes like, get ready for this, coffee. That's what they decided. It's coffee flavored. The two new flavors are classic Colombian and Italian espresso. Coffee Melt says, or Coffee Mate says, it's for people who just want something more fancy than a plain cup of coffee, but they don't want to pay top dollar. Okay?
That sounds like me.
Lower your standards a touch.
Yeah, that sounds a little like me.
Hey, good coffee, drink of weather. We got a lot of rain out there this afternoon. Here's a current look at radar around the metro. Another look at this and our forecast for tomorrow coming up. Keep the umbrella nearby if you're stepping out this evening. Even into the overnight, we're going to keep the chance for scattered showers. And notice that number tomorrow morning, going to be a good bit warmer. Lows now near 70 for tonight. Tomorrow afternoon is a better chance to see a stronger thunderstorm, maybe even some good downpours that could trigger a few flood alerts. But overall, it looks like most of us should get by A-OK tomorrow. Just minus a few isolated areas see some stronger impacts. For the weekend, we're expecting to dry out, highs in the upper 80s, and another cool down next week.
That is our time for now. News 12 at 6 o'clock after a short break. See you then.
Terrible, not only for figuring out school, but also for businesses. But tonight we do have some good news.
Right. We've learned so many businesses want to come to the Augusta area. We seem to be running out of space for more. Brady Trappin, the live for us over the Augusta Corporate Park. And Brady, from the look of it here, it looks like there's a lot of open space there behind you.
Yeah, Richard, guys, there's more than 800 acres of land cleared and ready to build out here at the Augusta Corporate Park. And businesses are choosing to come here because there is so much space. And yes, there's not much space anywhere else in Augusta.
Excitement level in our office is probably one of the highest it's ever been.
Yes, Cal Ray, the president of the Augusta Economic Development Authority, said that during a pandemic. Augusta is a finalist for 3 potential business development projects.
Those 3 themselves are north of $100 million in capital investment.
And they're the site of choice for an Asian company that could potentially invest $500 million. Economic Development is preparing up to 1,000 acres at the corporate park.
Existing square footage, we're out of space. That's why we need to get some under construction.
But many of these decisions are on hold due to, you got it, COVID-19.
Sometimes you can do by Zoom, but when you've got companies looking to invest this kind of money, they physically need to put their feet on the ground.
Still, the outlook locally is better. The unemployment rate in Augusta is down to 3% less than the U.S.
I'm getting orders from around the country now. It's not just local orders.
Jennifer Tinsley owns Field Botanicals downtown. She's pivoted part of her business to e-commerce, and now she's starting to get back on track.
I think it's settling down a bit. I think, you know, it's at least in retail, people are wanting to, they're feeling a little bit more secure financially, I think.
Now, an interesting part of these potential projects, most of it's manufacturing, which means many of these jobs are higher paying. And the Augusta Economic Development Authority says companies are attracted here because Plant Vogtle is close by, and also the Augusta area workforce is what they're looking for.
Well, we like to hear that, and I think we can certainly make some space for them. Brady, thank you.
to weather now. Let's have a live look outside. Thanks, Riley, very much. We're going to give you a live look now at New York from WABC up there. You can see people are gathering there. More protests are expected there in New York City and Louisville, all across the nation, just the day after the decision not to charge officers directly involved in Breonna Taylor's death with murder. Two officers were shot during protests last night in Kentucky. A suspect is behind bars in Louisville, charged with that attack. And the officers are expected to survive, but we'll be watching some of these live feeds coming in this evening from across the country.
Closer to home, a great tool to tell you about parents, an app to track your child's school bus. And both Richmond and Columbia counties have invested in this technology. Celeste Springer live in Columbia County. And Celeste, this is, where are you, Celeste? There you are. It's good to know that they have this technology, especially with it getting cooler, obviously on rainy days. This is good stuff.
Yeah, do you guys remember when your parents used to tell you they walked uphill both ways in the rain to school? Well, I guess kids nowadays do have it easier thanks to this app for Columbia County Schools bus tracking. It means that kids these days, I guess, won't need one of these as they wait for their bus. They'll be inside, and it also has big perks to parents, too. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. But let's be honest, it isn't always sunshine and rainbows.
So yeah, there's a lot of balancing acts. We do have dairy goats. The 7-year-old actually assists in milking goats. And so in the morning, you know, he's getting ready. He's going out with his dad. He's milking goats. And I'm in the house trying to balance everything else.
When we caught up with M. Coffee using Columbia County's new bus app, EduLog, Parent Portal Light, all this was going on. But even on good weather days, she says the app has its perks.
A lot of times, like just like in the morning, it's just like it helps keep the pace so that we can keep him focused.
And it provides a little entertainment on the side.
The kids love looking at the app and actually seeing the little yellow school bus and seeing it move.
Parents can find a full tutorial on how to get started online.
Our Columbia County website, which is ccboe.net, and there are 5 steps to load this app on your phone. And once you load it on your phone, you have to get a code from your school.
And there's safety benefits, too.
Being able to track when our kids are getting off the bus, when we should expect them at the bus stop. I think that's the best thing that I've noticed.
County has said that significantly cut down on phone calls to their office asking, where's my bus? And that's a big perk for bus drivers, too. They said, as of today, 2,500 families are signed up for the app.
Okay, I know, speaking as a mom, this sounds like a good thing. You like to know that it's moving, the bus is in action, makes you just feel a little safer. Celeste, thank you. And Richmond County also has their own bus tracker app, too, so we're going to put the details of both of those if you need to download that on WRDW.com.
Great use of technology. And speaking of school, high-stakes tests may be worth next to nothing this school year. The federal government did not want testing waived again, so Georgia school superintendent says he wants to make the end-of-course testing worth 0.01%. of a student's grade, which would not change that grade at all. Usually the test counts for about 20% of the final grade. The superintendent will make that recommendation at the state board meeting a week from today. We'll let you know what happens there.
It's about to be easier to get high-speed internet to people in rural areas in South Carolina. On the last day of session, lawmakers passed a handful of bills, including one that will help expand that broadband access. The bill would make it easier for companies to use power poles to bring their services to underserved areas. House members voted unanimously to pass this bill. Lawmakers say this is the first step in solving the state's rural broadband problem.
And this can also be an economic engine because companies want to go where they can have fast internet, good broadband. And from that, we can see an economic boom. We can see jobs being created. So there's a lot more out there if we expand this and build upon what we did today.
So that bill now heads to the governor's desk for his signature. And just a few days ago, the U.S. Department of Agriculture announced they'll be investing $7 million to help expand access to broadband in rural areas as well.
A petition in favor of Augusta Fire Chief Chris James is thrown out by the city. Firefighters complained the petition was being passed around while they were on the job working. Some firefighters did sign it, but they say since they were on the job, they felt intimidated to do that. The city signed it in favor of those firefighters. Meanwhile, fire department complaints are still being investigated.
An urgent message from Governor Kemp today asking Georgians to fill out the census.
The list of canceled events seems to grow by the day. Just yesterday, we told you the Blessing of the Hounds in Aiken is not happening. The day before, it was the Western Carolina State Fair canceled.
And another event on this long list, the annual Oliver Hardy Festival in Harlem. But Nick Proto talks to a young artist who's keeping the spirit of the festival alive.
Just try to kind of keep the legacy living here, even though, like, something like this happened.
For more than 30 years, thousands have filled these streets on the first Saturday of October for the Oliver Hardy Festival.
I just think it's really cool that someone so big and inspiring to many people came from a small town like this.
For 19-year-old Hannah Lewis, it's about more than just her small town. It's about family.
Well, my grandfather, his name is James B. Lewis, and he used to be the mayor of Harlem for 13 years. Because we're related to Oliver Hardy, he started the Oliver Hardy Festival.
She just started an art business and was hoping to set up a booth this festival. Instead of seeing the cancellation as an obstacle, she saw an opportunity, making pandemic-themed t-shirts to sell.
I just think it's like a fun, like, way to look at it. Instead of being sad it's canceled, we can be like, okay, yeah, it's canceled, but we'll have it again next year, or we'll find a substitute for it.
The shirts have been going fast.
Around here, they're selling very well because everyone here is, like, obsessed with Oliver Hardy.
Orders are even coming in from overseas. Stan Laurel's the other half of the comedy duo, and people from his hometown in England have bought some. As for if she'll continue to make shirts for the festival...
I hope so. I don't hope for another pandemic, but, I do hope that I can continue with t-shirt designs.
In Harlem, Nick Proto... side.
Really a creative design she came up with, but if you want to order one of those shirts or see what other things Hannah has made, you can head over to our website, wrdw.com.
Yeah, Harlem loves that festival, and so do people from all over the country. They come into town for it.
Hopefully next year we'll bounce back with that one too. Congratulations to Stevens Creek Elementary School for being named the National Blue Ribbon School. That is a big deal. The program says students at Stevens Creek have opportunities in the arts, foreign language, engineering, coding, and hold many, many fundraisers. Stevens Creek is one of the fewer than 400 Blue Ribbon schools all across America. That includes these other four in our area, including South Aiken High on the South Carolina side.
We are tracking a good bit of shadow.
This ad.
Well, as a lot of us are still drying out, we know we get a lot of rain around here. Our winters usually are not too cold. And this makes our area perfect for raising 100% grass-fed and free-range cattle.
We didn't realize that until just now. Riley Hale went over to Burke County to visit the largest grass-fed and free-range dairy farm in the nation.
Here in the CSRA, we have a lot of heat and a lot of water, which is great for growing grass and this special type of farming.
It's a bitter environment for them.
Hart Dairy in Burke County is the largest 100% grass-fed and free-range dairy farm in the country. This method is not the norm in the United States for raising dairy cattle, but it is one of the fastest-growing segments of the dairy industry.
And as consumers become more aware of what's in their food, where it comes from, how is it produced, are the animals treated well, there's a definite shift, a consumer shift, towards things like grass-fed.
When we look at, like, the longevity of them, the production that we get from them, our herd health system, I can tell from that, you know, we have happy cows.
Different types of grass are grown during different times of year for the cattle to graze. They are currently growing Bermuda, but will switch to rye and oats during cooler months. This allows for grazing 365 days a year. A recent study performed by the University of Georgia and University of Florida found that the farm also extracts tons of carbon from the atmosphere.
It's about 3.5 tons of carbon per year, per acre, that we pull out of the atmosphere. So we're pretty proud of that. Not only do we think this is better for the animals, we think it's better for the environment in the long term.
Hart Dairy is in the process of opening a processing facility in Waynesboro to help them ship their product across the southeast. And the great news is you can actually buy some of Hart Dairy's products coming soon around the Augusta area. And it was a lot of fun out there heading out to Hart Dairy and just in Burke County, right near Shell Bluff, kind of if you're familiar with that portion of central Burke County. But this specific cow was the friendliest of the bunch. It came right up to us. It was eating our pants. It was eating my shoes. And just having a great time out there. So me and Mikkel had a lot of fun heading out there to Burke County.
There's always the one cow that's going to come up and say hello that way. But you say the products are going to be locally available soon, right?
Definitely so. Once they open up that facility in Waynesboro, they're hoping to bring in a lot of jobs to Burke County with that and also be able to ship across the southeast. So now they're currently only in Atlanta shopping centers, but They are going to be in the Augusta area sometime soon, most likely within the next couple weeks.
All because of our perfect climate. How do you like that?
There you go. And we see a lot of rain for sure. And more rain in the forecast out there this evening and tonight. So if you do have any plans to maybe head out this evening, we are expecting this rain to continue. Overall, the severe weather threat from what's left of Beta moving through the area, that severe weather threat is going to be Friday afternoon for us. So what we're going to see the next 12 hours or so should be manageable for us, just light to moderate rainfall. They are nuisance.